Well, bloody loaded. Locked and loaded. We got wood, barbecue, a wood burner, charcoal seats, four and a quad.
Hey guys, today we're going to my great grandpa's boathouse in the Strangford Lock.
Castle
Ward.
Cool.
Hey guys, today, just like that, we're at Strangford already, and we are just having chips and beer for our lunch, but I was having chips.
Well, you had a wee bit of beer in there?
No. Just, yeah. And I know I'm practicing my chant there, and I can actually do it without thinking. Now we're going to give you a tour of Strangford.
And then what?
We'll head on to the boathouse in Strangford.
Oh, and what did Margie get?
Today we're going to take you on a tour of the all the boats and stuff
in the town of Strangford.
Yeah, cool.
Come on, you hold it. Do not hit the red the thing, and we'll have a wee coffee. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The port, coffee port.
Can I get a large Americano, please?
Sick.
That's how you're going, Grace. And do you like a kids? Or talking about like something like that.
Yep.
He makes wee videos of like his secrets that I feel you're at.
Yeah.
There's the big ferry. It's taking you to Portaferry. Where is Portaferry?
It's over there.
It's right over there.
Yeah.
Right there.
Jimmy McElhagger? No. You remember that Strangford sailing club?
Yeah, but
like
it was in the late 60s for you, know? You're a kid, like, you get young or old, and then you're a bit old, and you're like, oh, it's pretty young. His mother grandfather lived this in 1995, so 20 years of boating that I started on. Yeah, actually, you went to pet shop in Belfast, you did from Carmelis. That's really good. But this is just passion. So, last time we were all here together was when we had to clear it out.
No, I didn't actually trust habit. 2003 or 4.
Oh, wait, 57?
Just a walk on boat, a drive on boat,
ferry. Do you want no, just black. Nice.
Cool.
I moved my brother's come out just before What? Yeah? Yeah. Yeah. Where? Oh, yeah, yeah. Plymouth Pilot. Oh, crap. I don't have a dog bag. Run over to that guy and say, excuse me, you don't have a plastic bag? My dad forgot to bring a dog bag. The coffee shop man. Go quick. Plastic bag, Henry. Bring me it. Well, I was not lucky. Doctors are shite and Henry finds dog bags. Will you hold that?
Do you want to carry this? There's another wheelbarrow for me. Here you go.
Margie, please stop pulling. Margie, stop pulling. Look at all the wood now, honey. Ow.
One more night. One more day. One more day.
Yeah. Round and around and around and around. It's like a wee town in Donegal, isn't it, honey? Is that a pallet in there, honey? Is there a pallet in there? Maybe the baby one. Aye. Alright, tell us about these different shops and then we'll go around to the other place. Yeah. Bags of wood there. Yeah, they're using meal bags, aren't they? There's a van or a truck. Oh. That's that bar. Oh. That's that bar we couldn't go to one time, Henry. And then this is kind of it, isn't it? It's a really nice place we went to once, remember? Kayaks just sitting there. Go down. That's kind of it, Henry, I think. Right, where next? Henry.
Lock.
Oh, Henry. Where are we going to next?
Shrinkford Lock.
Oh, the destination, final destination.
Well, boathouse in Shrinkford Lock. Hey guys, we made it and we're at the Shrinkford Lock.
The boathouse, Henry?
Yeah.
Grandpa's boathouse.
Take a video,
Henry.
Yep. I'm just dying for water. lost in here.
Night. Looks like we made it.
Who owns the boat house night?
National Trust. You take the dog, Henry. Wait, that's not it, that's a shed. That's it down now. No, down there. I went the wrong way. I wasn't thinking. Now I'm going wee-wee. La 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 la. Looks like we made it. Da, 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 da. No, but John fixed it. No, Uncle John came up and fixed it. Yeah.
Alright guys, so we're gonna unload the top now.
I've got this one here too. Just at the door, at the big door. Oh, here he is. The worker man. Load it up, workman. Workman Henry. Poor Margie. Imagine Grandpa rebuilding that. Round and around and around and around and around. Here he comes, the worker boy. Right, don't be going down the steps, that. Take it up and then set up at the top and then put the other smaller one that's down and then come back to that. Just don't want to trip. Yeah, and then pick up the wee rotty bits. We can burn these too. I was a highwayman. Boy. Show us what you caught. Show me. Did you say you caught a mussel too? And you light the fire, didn't you? Good lad. Where's your lip? Show me your lip. Cool. When your wee cousins arrive. We're way ahead of everyone, aren't we? Yeah, we're setting up.
been fucking Collins here.
Our Uncle Collins here, see? We'll be touching bring back memories. Just in there. Oh, she has like, who's this? I was like, oh, I was cursing under my breath. No, a foreigner coming up here, clogging up our roads. You just, I think in here. How's he going? Look at James. Yeah, and I saw Dublin Reds and I was like, oh, he is. His girlfriend. Alright, boys. Did you?
That's good. Guys, have you got a spot?
Yeah. I'll set up. And the guy says we can get the queue form. He's just in the courtyard.
Mm-hmm.
So.
So it's off.
Have you lit?
Yeah, what?
Have you lit?
Yeah, all good. You can smell it?
Okay, I brought a torch and all the light.
All right, I know, I just used petrol and, uh-huh. And I got brought a load of my wood. So.
Yes. I'll tell you, it's further in than I thought from before.
Yeah.
So it is.
I think I can like slightly remember, but. Maybe a touch more, but like, it's just Colin to come, I think. He could have parked there. Alright. And then, sort of quarterly delivery. Alyssa contraband. Alright, my cigar's off, James. just carry him and I'll deal with. Just carry him and I'll deal with. No, just carry him and leave all that there and I'll bring him.
Hey guys, it's Henry Spencer and all the customers.
And who are you? Just they don't know who anyone is, like that's the thing about it, because it's been locked down. I'm just making a home video. Who are you?
James
Spencer. Who are you?
Colin Michael Hagen.
What? Yeah.
Hello.
Who are you?
Good, thanks.
Who are you?
Oh.
I'm just making a home video, but like nobody knows each other.
Laura.
Laura Mac. Okay. And who's this Dylan?
Dylan McElhaga.
Dylan's the first to meet him, another bars.
Oh, he's hit me,
boy.
That's fine. He was like that. He was like that.
Hello, Brian. Thanks, Brian and Leanne, very much for organising this.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure Jimmy would be smiling down on us from up above.
I know.
And the wonderful job, the original doors that he's got made.
Well, the bits of iron or whatever they are, steel.
Uh huh.
How much?
I think that was always left, Brian.
I know. Uh-huh. Amazing. Who are you? Ben, yeah, who are you? Who are you?
Mama.
There's nobody, all of you ones don't really, you're not familiar with everyone. You're Julie?
Yes, I'm Julie. Giving out the coffee and the cokes. Would you like one, Brian?
No, I'm okay. Thanks.
What would you like?
Who are you?
Yeah.
Who are you?
Like
yeah. I think a lot of these don't need work. Mary Kate doesn't know anyone.
No. Katie, I am Katie. Your cousin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just making a wee home video for Mary Kate. So, who are you?
I follow you on Instagram. I love your
did he say that?
Anna said that.
Oh, aye. What's your name? What?
There's a telegram. Ollie.
Hi. Yeah.
Robbie.
Charlie. Are you pretending to be shy?
What's your name?
Charlie.
Who's this? Hi. He's out over there. What's your name? Mary Kate, what's your name?
Mary Kate.
Who's this here?
What's
his name?
Who's that?
Billy. Yeah. Who are you?
Henry.
Is that one on it? Who's that, Henry? Henry. Who's that? I can give you the key and take my back. That's Laura. See? And he's like, who's that? He's like, I don't know. That's Laura, that's Uncle Collins. Partner, girlfriend. Henry. Come here. Henry, come here. Come here.
Put your hand out. Put your hand out.
It's a strong!
Henry, that.
Did you marry Kate the week past? Knowledge. Remember that
applause? Oh my word, it's still alive. Henry. Henry. Who's that? Who's that?
Look at this. Oh, they see the crab. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Can I end the other one? Oh, there's no water in this one either.
Oh.
What am I
going to
do with it? Back on?
Yeah, our Mary Kate's real hardy.
Was the water not cold? No?
Yeah, I think it Mary Kate did not. Henry. Henry. Who's that there? Who is it?
Colin.
Are you joking there, or do you know who it is? That's Leanne's. Yeah. Maybe it's a deck there.
Decided that when the tide is out, there's an awful lot of dirt and everything to go down where you've got slippery there.
Yeah.
We don't want people just walking through wood. So far, there's been a bit of a disagreement. We were
going to
away beyond this.
Beyond here.
Uh-huh. Exactly, yeah.
The tide has to be
very far out.
What do we need to open the boathouse?
Just to have a wee look. You see the plaque and all?
Guys, you let me open up this door for you. I'll show you where the plaques are.
Game of Thrones in the back, sir. This is a Michael Haggie here, there, Julie.
That's a Michael Haggie. You're responsible for this carry on, eh?
Yes, ma'am.
Take responsibility.
Oh, he's an actual Michael Haggie. And there's another stone there on the other side, Anna. You can't really see it though. The only reason I knew about them, we came once and it was broken into.
Yeah, so. Exactly. So we heard it was a
metal haggis. No, John came up, his dad came up like the next day and fixed it, I think. Didn't he? Him and Andrew. Don't you get this cigar on you?
Spend all my money on you all over this town.
Cool, isn't it? I never even register for them as a child. And as a child, it's so much bigger because you're down here and like, it's just.
Like it's, it is massive, like, but it's not as big as.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah. Yeah. But it's literally, when you're a kid, it's like a fucking warehouse.
His dad was on golf course with the Transport Museum, right? And we, a couple of the boys and I, went across the Irving Harbour there one day, put it in a trailer, and I took it up to a big shed, massive shed, down near where they do the filming now in Titanic Quarter.
Yes, yes,
and
yeah.
The boat went in, and there was hover car, model boats, there was old cars, there was a DeLorean. This place was huge, and that boat was in there.
Yeah.
Probably still in there.
Oh, we showed them.
We showed the photograph.
No, it's just Will. For me to see whenever my mum unveiled it.
Oh, why? Jim has them.
Who has
the sign? What did we do with them? Lost it. Who had the photo? Where's the
leak?
The photograph is the
May we all get to see those fields of green turn gold. Watch a marching band pray with the harvest moon coming up. And know that 15 minutes of fame or sing will be a bridge's butt. We'll all be watching the TV the day that it comes. May we all know that nothing ain't cool till you wear the new one. Sound of a quarter on the down the streets. Hit the Travis Trade right up the road to the before we get lost down the front door. Snowing with the top out the back of the car. I have no idea what you're expecting. You know what his rent was? Yes, not right, Julie? Something like that. No, 50 pounds a year. Whereas I kind of them to die. And nobody wants to continue it, you know. But then, I must have expanded on this, you know. I suppose that's kept the trust, the ownership and the trust and stuff, and kept everything legal.
But first of all, I'd like to thank Will for a bit of his time here and opening up the old boathouse and certainly giving us a bit of knowledge and history.
Absolutely, it's a pleasure, John. I mean, at the end of the day, we're in a beautiful part of the world here. Strangford Loch's an area of outstanding natural beauty, but also scientific interest. And the interesting thing about this particular place is that it was built purposely for the seaweed off the shore, because one of the things they actually did out here was actually use the seaweed to fertilize the ground and to feed the animals. And in actual fact, they won European Farming Awards. So the Ward family were that good at it that they won these awards, because it went from farm to plate, as they like to talk about these days in top restaurants, that basically they didn't have to season it. It tasted so good.
And many cattle did you say they had?
About 15,000 here at one stage, you know. One of the things that the cattle did was actually keep down the bracken and the heath that was on the outer lands. You see, they had an awful lot more land than what is available right now. At the moment, there's just under 1,000 acres that the National Trust actually own here at Castle Ward. And these lands, basically, there's part of it rented out to local farmers, and they still keep the cattle on it, which is really good. But as I say, in general, you would have cattle keeping down the bracken quite a lot, which was one of the things that made sure. I mean, it's a bit like goats on the grass and stuff like that. Everything's all kept, and it brings up the flora and fauna from other parts of the land, so that you wouldn't actually have if you just let it grow, because the bracken and all would actually smother it all.
They probably knew about methane. Nothing about methane at no stage.
No, probably not. Yes, yeah.
15,000 cattle.
I would say yes, exactly. So you wouldn't be. You wouldn't be wanting to be sort of, what's the word, so eco-friendly. Your nose wasn't sort of purified by all of that, you know.
And do we have a sense of like when it was built then, late 1800s?
Yeah, this is early Victorian, this particular part. You have to remember the Ward family came here and set up Old Castle Ward about 1610. And then there was later a sort of modern extension in Victorian times in 1858. So this would have been built similar time.
Wow, 1858, wow.
Well, thank you very much for your time.
No, thank you. Glad to meet you, actually.
And we'll get you some of those photographs.
Billy clapping his hand.
It's a pleasure to meet somebody who has actually done something here that is actually of value and sort of adds to the whole thing. Well,
Jimmy's up there. We hope.
No, he's looking down, going, yeah. What's that crew doing right now? Have these places booked or what?
She's
a she's a lawyer, like, so she's ready to get the ready to get her whatever her law books out. But
hi there. Now I'm a giant. Very good, giving him so much of his time. I can't get a lot of the seaweed corn.
Yeah, well there you are. Go anywhere I go. Do the best I can. Raise him up the right way. Hoping that he
someday wants to be like his old man. Yeah. Just to get him locking up, and then that'll be the end of it. Or you can even take a photo of us all. Yeah.
Henry! Come here!
Over here, quick! Freyus, Boreus, Tybius! Some of your friends!
You gonna get a photo, Mary Kate? Who's got the best camera? I'm no battery, you might, or I'll get, I don't know. You get to...
Right, Robbie!
Go stand up. Sorry, Jim.
Right? Oh! Hey!
Guys, all the very best.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Will.
There you are, Jim. Bye.
Who wants to go home? Who wants to go home?
Yeah.
You will
COVID.
Cheers.
Cheers. Very cute. Not yet, not. Come on, you up here.
One up here with all the people. Do you want me to carry that for you? Are you got 38? Do you want me to carry you?
Was it double park or something?
There you are.
Everybody's got.
Thank you, everybody, really? From coming from all over the world.
I think a Michael Hager representative should be up there.
Across the water. Across the water.
I'm not a Michael Hager proper.
Lovely to be here, Island Hill Boathouse, and very much thank you to Jimmy and Amy and all the work and effort they put into getting this place back to the state that it's in today. And we heard there from a guy from the National Trust that's very much appreciated. Colin?
Hello, good to see everyone. It's been a long time. Nice to meet all the boys as well. I'm Mary Kate. And yeah, no, it's I'm Billy as well. no, it's great to be back here. Yeah, reminiscing
off
our childhood, so good to see everyone. Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's just very special for everyone to come together and take the time out. James coming from Dublin.
Yeah, do you love that?
Colin and Laura, especially coming over here, jetting over here from London and from Tark.
We almost forgot, but let's not forget Bran and Leanne for organising this and having the idea and putting it all together. So, Bran, Leanne,
well,
Jimmy, Amy. Lift your glasses. Cheers.
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 Cheers. Down the hatch. Down to one. Down to one. Quick. Down to one.
Cheers. Cheers, Mary Kate.
Cheers.
Oh, I'd like your shackles.
Watch you.
Oh. There's a hole in your. Watch, Anna. Watch the. Watch the.
Cheers.
Watch. Doesn't spell more.
We got one eight. We're going to go back home.
What did you get? Let me see.
I'll tell you very briefly that I opened a box that was under the bed a fortnight ago, and it was mostly a talk Katie in relation to Grandpa, my dad, and it was letters that he had written in his teens and letters that were written to him, and he just came across as being such a like an upright, understanding, like kind, like, what do you call it, man of integrity?
Yeah.
So we did. And it was so much to do with scouts.
Oh,
I was organising so much, coming down here, field trips, and all different events that he was planning. You know, so he seemed to be an organiser. He loved life, you know, and wanted to live it to the full. Yeah. You know,
what age is he in these?
He was in his late teens.
Jesus, we're kind of mature, then he's organised stuff.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. And then in amongst it, there would be a leaf that my mum had found in Old Crescent when she was going to meet Jimmy.
Yeah.
And a receipt for their a receipt for their engagement ring whenever she was 16, he was 17.
Wow.
You know, so many cards from him to her and her to him. How much
WhatsApp messages?
How much they love each
yeah,
other.
Yeah, wow. Very sweet.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But you know the little box of milk tray that were always in Gran's fridge?
Oh yeah.
Isn't that like
yeah.
so
sweet? He's given them to her, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's some love that they had.
So tell us why, so of all the places to end up, Castle Ward, I didn't always totally get that because there's many other parts in Northern Ireland be a bit more well known. So why did they end up here?
Exactly, because of the scouts and bringing the scout troop down here for some reason. I'd love to know why the scout troop chose here.
Yeah.
But that was the, your dad, Colin, probably knows.
Yeah.
I must check with John. What brought him to such a strange place?
Yeah. Yeah, more Korean. I would have been, in my mind, people go more Korean and
Bangor? Put on.
Yeah. Tonic could be here.
I
don't
know. Me?
All right, you can sign off from the last remaining Michael Hager. All right, say bye to everyone.
All right, see you later. Bye bye, everyone.
Thanks for watching.
Yeah.
Thank you. Smash subscribe.
Click the link below.
Right, Charles.
What do you say?
You Charles Maximus,
eh? You wave bye and say.
What are you drinking there?
Oh. What's the angle? Let me see. Any alcohol in that?
Get it in one, Charlie.
Do you remember that, the blue one that we had? Big.
What?
Big.
Brian's going to get you. Now go up past Brian. Go up past Brian up there. Ollie, look out at Brian and give a wave.
Oh my goodness, I'll have to put that on private on YouTube so Anna doesn't see. Like, look at them holding on so tight. James, do you remember the ones in the Game and Country Fair? Yeah.
Brian, can I
have one more go? Yeah, well, we'll go up and see this man here.
How are
you
going
to
get in there, Brian?
Can I, Brian?
I don't know, we'll work it out.
Can I ride it up to the man?
Here, you take a video of us walking up
to the man. Brian, can I ride it up to the man?
Well, say to your granda there, if you can get on.
Robbie! Robbie! Robbie, get me
home!
Come
back,
we're
over. Yeah.
That's not a bad day, James. That shouldn't stop.
Yeah. It's for September time.
Brilliant. One breath.
Yeah. Now do your